Hey Alex, so this week as punishment for not finishing my Generation A review on time, I'm going to be reviewing Catch 22 by Joseph Heller at your suggestion. And by suggestion, I mean order. It wouldn't be a punishment if I could say no to you, would it? Catch 22 is the story of John Yossarian, a bombardier in the U.S. Air Force, and his attempts to be discharged from duty. Yossarian has already flown the number of missions required by the U.S. Air Force, but his commanding officer, Colonel Cathcart, keeps raising the number of missions he requires. And Yossarian can't disobey this order in favor of the earlier order because it would be disobeying a superior officer. Pay attention to this sort of bureaucratic incompetence is kind of important in this book. Throughout the novel, we learn about Yossarian's past missions, meet some of his fellow soldiers, and learn that war is, surprise, not a really great thing. The title of the novel refers to one of the many problems Yossarian faces in his attempts to get discharged. Catch-22 states that if you are insane, you don't have to fly. However, if you recognize that flying is essentially suicide and that you don't want people to kill you, you are quite obviously sane. Therefore, you have to continue flying. Therefore, the insane people are the ones who enjoy it, and thus never draw their insanity to attention. So essentially, Yossarian's problem is that because he believes everyone is trying to kill him, he's too sane. Kind of hurts your brain, doesn't it? Imagine 400 pages of this. Now, when you first told me to read Catch-22, I was actually okay with it. I mean, it's one of those classic books, right? It shows up on all the top 100 lists. It's very highly recommended, and I figure that everyone should read it at least once in their life. However, it took me a long time to get through it. I don't know why this was. I mean, I read it at every opportunity I had. Chapter 6, Hungry Joe. That's enough for today. And it still took over a week to get through. That's a long time when you don't have work or school going on. Now, before I get into my opinion on this book, I just want to make one thing clear. I have a lot of friends who think that quality is subjective, that there is nothing good nor bad, but thinking makes it so. I am not one of these people. I think that quality can be measured objectively, and that my favorite book is not necessarily a good book, and that books that I hate might not necessarily be bad, I just might not be able to stand them. And I feel that after your Wuthering Heights review, where you were able to go through the book and point out exactly what it was you didn't like it in an academic fashion, I should be able to do the same for this book. And I tried, I really, really tried. The fact of the matter is, maybe Catch-22 is a brilliant book. Maybe it was outstanding for its time and its portrayal of war and parodying of an entire culture and being able to revolutionize mine. I have no idea. I hated it. I mean, look at this. Look how freaking huge this book is, and I dare you to turn to any page and find something remotely interesting. First, I want to talk a bit about one person who really pissed me off while reading this book. It wasn't Yossarian. It wasn't Colonel Cathcart and his raising the missions required. It wasn't even Milo and his stupid syndicate and his willingness to bomb his own people because he would get a profit and therefore that's good for the country. How does that logic even make sense in twisted bureaucratic world? It wasn't Joseph Heller for writing it, and it wasn't even you for making me read it. Okay, it was kind of you for making me read it. But mostly it was the book reviewer for the New Republic who contributed the blurb that you see on the back of your edition. He or she called Catch-22 one of the most bitterly funny works in the language. Explosive, bitter, subversive, brilliant. See, it might just be me, but when I see a book described as bitterly funny, I expect to laugh at some point. I don't expect pages and pages of circular conversation making the exact same point. And what's really frustrating is that the point is there is no point. The point is that bureaucracy only contributes nothing, and that rules and regulations just get in the way of real things. And yes, that is a very good point to make, and yeah, well, it's good for you for, you know, actually demonstrating this. But you don't need to demonstrate it for 400 freaking pages! And while it was mildly amusing the first time, it was less so the second time, even less so the third time, and by the time I was 200 pages in, I kind of wanted to stab myself in the eye. I mean, not that writing a book around an idea is inherently a bad thing. I mean, look at George Orwell, that's all he ever did, and yet he was an excellent writer, and his books are fun to read. Maybe it would have been a better contrast if the lighter parts of the book were actually, you know, funny. But as it is, it's just, ah! Maybe I'm not giving the reviewer at the New Republic enough credit. I mean, it just says in the language. I mean, it doesn't say the English language. Maybe he read, like, a French translation that was absolutely brilliant. Maybe we should get the French to translate all our work. You never know. And I know that literature has always been used for communication and for greater social change, but the problem is, when you're writing a novel, you have to remember at some level that you're writing a piece of entertainment. It has to be entertaining. One of the reasons this book is so hard to get into is that there's a whole lot of characters. Now, I don't mind lots of characters in fiction. In fact, it's one of my favorite things. But these characters need to be well-developed, well-thought-out. They need to give a sense to a world beyond the limited point of view of our main characters. In Catch-22, Teller just throws names at us. He doesn't give them any identifiable personality. There's maybe, like, three characters who I can remember. Characters will show up for one chapter, they'll have some random quirk, and then they'll just disappear again. And when they reappear, it turns out, ha, guess what? They're insane. Whoa, everyone in war is insane. Why would you fight a war if you were sane? War is bad. Are you getting that? The only character I had any feelings for at all was Yossarian. And I spent the whole book wanting to call him Yoshi because I was playing Paper Mario at the time. If I was forced to write down the main traits of Yossarian, I would come up with, he doesn't want to be in a war, and he has sex. That's not enough to make a three-dimensional character. That's barely enough for two. That is like a line right there. We don't feel for Yossarian because he's a well-written character who we want to be successful. We feel for him because the situation he's in sucks. That's not good writing. One day I was walking to school and I fell in a hidden quicksand pit and I drowned. There, bet you feel bad for me now, but it has nothing to do with my personality. It has to do with the fact that I walked into a quicksand pit and drowned. Okay, so maybe that's not the best example. I'm sorry, we can't all be bitterly funny and write one of the most brilliant works in the language. I don't know, Catch-22 could have been a brilliant short story or a novella, if I'm being generous. But it does not need 400 pages of tiny, tiny writing. Oh my god! So, yeah, I give it one witty Catch-22 reference out of one. I can't even think of one. My brain is so fried. Alex, I'll see you next week when you review Like Water for Chocolate for your punishment. I only hope that I'll cause you as much pain as you caused me. And Alex, I'm sorry this review was kind of rambling and circuitous and didn't really go anywhere. Hey, that's just like all the dialogue in the novel. Yeah, I get it. See, because we're so bound up in the little details, like whether this book sucks or whether this officer is saying the correct phrasing, that we don't focus on the greater things, like the fact that lots of people are dying in war. Will you stop? Maybe this book isn't good. Maybe it does have the ability to change society and have a great impact on people's lives. You think I won't hit you just because you're me at a slightly different camera angle? I will hit you. Yeah, see, but that would make you crazy. But since I'm you and I would realize you're crazy, I would also realize that I'm crazy and therefore I would be sane because I would realize, oh my god, just make it stop.